what Jesus is referring to when he talks about the old order and his apostles, and when Andrew talked about John, he's referring to John the Baptist. And John the Baptist was a cousin of Jesus, and he was destined to go before Jesus and prepare the way, so to speak, with the Jewish people that what John would consider the Messiah was coming. And his main message was repent, repent, and which was necessary. There is a place for that. But John was very intense, and he was very attached to all of the Jewish ceremonies and traditions. He is the one that introduced baptism, and Jesus said, well, that's a good ceremony. It's not necessary, but if it's meaningful for you, then do it. And he even went to John the Baptist and had him baptize him. And baptism is the idea of washing away the old order in you, which is basically your lower nature. I liked how they name foolish fears, diverse lusts, enslaving pleasures, malice, envy, and vengeful hatred. And when you think about each one of those things, though at first they may be very tantalizing, especially lusts and pleasures, they enslave you. They take away your joy and your spontaneity. We all know what it is to be fear-ridden. It's a terrible thing. And what Jesus said is that he came for a new order, and it was basically transformation of the inner person. A transformation of your thinking processes, your perceptions of reality, and how you respond to circumstances that come up. It was a change of mind and a change of heart. And the only way you can really do that, where it's of depth, is with the Spirit that is within you. And we have the Holy Spirit of the Universe Mother, and we have the fragment of the Universal Father who works in our minds and helps adjust and redirect our thoughts. And then when Jesus left this planet, he left the gift of the Spirit of Truth that will help us resonate with the higher way and what is truly truth, and will show the way. And so we refer to that as the threefold Spirit within us that can help us. That's what Jesus is talking about, that he wants to transform. That was what his religion was, to transform us, to get us out of our fears and our concerns and our selfishness. And I used to be a very selfish person, wanting what I wanted and, well, you know, it's like survival, and then pretty soon we become, it moves from self-survival to selfishness. And my father, God bless him, he used to get on my case as a child, and he had very high standards for me, and he used to always say, you are so selfish, you have to outgrow being so selfish, you have to be thinking of others. And that never left me. And I didn't just sit down and say, well, I'm going to no longer be selfish and then deny myself. I was transformed because I brought it to God and asked to help change me inside, to transform me. So I give that because that's just, I know what Christ is talking about to his apostles. It's, you know, and it is a transformation. And Christianity, so many different aspects of Christianity and denominations focus on the old order of John the Baptist teachings of repent. Well, yes, we do have to repent. But if we flagellate ourselves and we change, we transform with the help of the Spirit, that's what Jesus gave, so that it didn't seem like it was such a sacrifice or such a denial. It was becoming liberated and freed. And the only way you can do that is to experience it yourself. But it has happened to me, and I'm very grateful for that. So Anyway, thank you very much for listening. And
holy city, holy city, holy city, holy city.